Hi friends, a very good afternoon to all of you guys, and this is Tanu, one of the PT trainers with Aussies Clayton. Guys, today I am back here with one of the informative sessions for PTE. If you have any questions about the scores, if you're not achieving your desired score in any of the modules, please feel free to post it in the comment section and I'll be more than happy to answer your query. And if you're struggling with one of the modules, you are more than welcome to post your scores and I'll be able to give you a feedback for the same. And today we will be talking about two very important questions of PTE. First one is called retell lecture and second one is called summarize spoken text. They both are very important modules for the listening section because they both contribute quite heavily towards listening. Moreover, retell lecture also contributes marks towards your speaking, whereas summarize spoken text contribute marks towards your writing. So these two tasks are actually giving scores towards the four modules, which is speaking, writing and listening. To begin with, we will start with the retell lecture. Retell lecture is a part of your speaking module. It is the question number four of your speaking. So the first question is your read aloud, second is your repeat sentences, third is your describe image, and fourth is the retell lecture. Now there is one thing which has little bit, you know, earlier people used to get just 2 to 3 retell lectures, but nowadays people are getting 4 to 5 retell lectures, which is, you know, causing a little bit of trouble with many students. What is happening is, in retell lecture we don't get any time, we just get 10 seconds before we need to speak loudly. So once the audio stops, you only have 7 to 10 seconds and we have to speak loudly into the microphone and retell what we have just heard. So you have 5 or 4 retells, one after the other, back to back, which is getting a little bit tiring with many students, and they're not able to take notes, enough notes, and they're not able to speak for enough time. So the best way to overcome this fear is that when you are practicing retell lecture, please make sure you practice 4 to 5 retells together, one after the other. You can check your answers, you can, you know, open the transcript and check them later, but just make sure you practice them one after the other so that you get into the habit of, you know, taking the notes one after the other for at least 4 to 5 retell lectures. Now, as I said, that this task contribute marks towards your listening and your speaking. Speaking is all about your fluency, as I've already mentioned in many of the videos before. Speaking is mainly your fluency, pronunciation and intonation. But as you know, the scores are also going towards listening. Listening is basically the content. So if you're good with the content, you should be able to score very good in this task. And until and unless you don't score good in this task, it is really hard to achieve your desired scores in the listening module. So guys, whenever you will do this task, please make sure you have plenty of notes, because retell itself means repeat. Okay, so what you basically have to repeat is content. And if you will not have any notes, what will happen is you will forget once you start to speak. Many times we think, oh, we can memorize it, we can recall it. But trust me, when you are giving the exam, you won't be able to recall anything. So please make sure you take enough notes and try to take neat notes. Many times what happens is that you take plenty of notes, you write very quickly. In your exam, you will be getting a notepad, erasable notepad, and you take notes there. So many times when you take notes, you take notes which are not, you know, you are not only able to understand those notes, your own handwriting. So please make sure, guys, that when you take notes, they are neat. Use plenty of arrows, use plenty of abbreviations, inverted commas, you know, just anything that can help you write quickly. Because if you write quickly, you will be able to capture more of keywords. Another thing is that when you are taking notes, please don't stop and think, this is not important word, this is not a keyword, so I will not write it. Don't decide there and then what is important and what is not important. Every single word in the lecture is important. Of course, keywords are important, but please don't ignore the other words too. Okay, so please make sure, don't stop writing in between the lecture. Don't think that this is not important, this is important, this is not important. Don't, you know, analyze the keywords within when the lecture is going on. Make sure You take notes and then you see what is important and what is not important. Another thing, in retail lecture, intonations are very important. Moreover, fluency is very important. So whatever notes you have to, you've taken, please make sure you speak very fluently. Okay. For example, if the lecture is about, say, importance of PTE exam, so make sure when you are speaking, the speech is free flowing. Grammar is not very important in this task. Even if you say grammatically incorrect sentences, please don't panic. Okay. Don't focus too much on making the sentences grammatically correct. Rather focus more on, you know, speaking fluently and covering enough of the content. For example, as I said, the lecture is about, you know, importance of PTE exam. So you can simply start. There were many, you know, topics covered in the lecture, but the speaker was primarily talking about importance of PTE exam. Furthermore, in the lecture, he mentioned why PTE's exam is important. He also added that it covers 4 modules. He also mentioned that achieving 90 will give a student 20 residency points. Furthermore, he described dash. Moreover, he mentioned dash. The speaker also highlighted dash. So all those dashes, try to make small sentences. Fill those dashes with the content you have. Okay, there is no need to make really long sentences. There is no need to make, you know, sentences that makes plenty of sense. So it doesn't matter even if it is not making much of sense. Doesn't matter if it, even a sentence is grammatically incorrect. What matters the most is the content, the similar words from the lecture. And second thing, what matters the most is your fluency. So just be careful about these two parts. Now, another important thing is for how long you have to speak when you are doing a retail lecture. You will be getting 40 seconds to give your response. In this task, I prefer you should speak for full 40 seconds. If not 40, anything more than 35. Because the more you speak, the more content you cover. The more content you cover, the better listening score you will get. So try to please make sure that you are speaking for at least 35 seconds. One after the other. Okay. So whenever you are sitting and practicing, please practice 4 to 5 retails. Now, from where to practice? There are plenty of resources, but guys, you have to pick a resource which is reliable. So, you know, you can practice from PTE Tutorials, which is an excellent website. You can go to ptetutorials.com and you can access plenty of material. You can also download Telegram Messenger. It has got, and you can, you know, join our group, which is also called PTE Tutorials. That group has got more than 16,000 members, and everyone, believe me, everyone in the group is really helpful. Students do help each other, and some of the students, without even taking coaching, they are getting such an amazing score. There are also teachers there which are, you know, helping students 24/7. So if you have any question, any query, you are more than welcome to join that group, access plenty of material which is posted there, or if you have any question, you can ask the teacher also. And we've got Jack Smith. Jack is saying hello. Hello, Jack. And Jayesh Chavla. Jayesh, you're most welcome. I hope it helps. So coming back to the next question, which we will be talking about, is summarize spoken text. Now, why I've chosen these two questions today is because a lot of students, they are very confused. They think that summarized spoken text is pretty much like retail lecture, or retail lecture is pretty much like summaries. Because in retail lecture also we summarize. No, retail word itself means repeat. So the more you repeat, the better marks you get. What you are repeating? Content. Okay. Whereas summarized spoken text, you will be again listening to the audio. This is the similarity. That in both the questions, you will listen to a lecture or an audio, but in retail, you repeat. In summarize, you summarize. What is the meaning of summary? Summary means overview of the whole passage. Overview means the key points, the main idea, the gist of the passage. So guys, when you are doing summarized spoken text, you are not repeating anything. You are basically summarizing all the small little points into grammatically correct sentences. Now, as I mentioned before, that the task gives marks towards writing also. Writing is all about grammar, writing is all about your spellings, and writing is about your written discourse. So your grammar is very important in this task. If you are writing grammatically incorrect sentences, then of course you will not be able to score very good marks in this task. So please make sure when you are doing summary, you write grammatically correct sentences. And we've got a question. Can we use templates for retail lecture, Jack? Of course, you should use a template for retail lecture, because templates acts like a skeleton. So they are basically the base, and you just simply add your content into that base, and you should be able to speak fluently. As I said, you know, furthermore, the speaker mentioned, moreover, he highlighted, in addition, he also added, the lecture also described about that. So, you know, you can add such words, firstly, secondly, furthermore, moreover, in addition, all those little words can actually help you to be very good with retail lecture. And we've got Sandeep, and Sandeep, hi Sandeep, he's asking, in speaking section, is more important between content, fluency and pronunciation? Sandeep, it completely depends which task you are talking about. Wherever the marks are just going towards speaking, then the fluency and pronunciation are very important. Wherever the marks are going towards reading and listening, content is very important. So what is reading? Reading is your content. What is listening? Listening is your content. For example, there is a task, read aloud. The marks are going towards speaking and reading. So both content, fluency, pronunciation are important. Now describe image. Where are the marks going? Describe image. The marks are going just towards speaking. What is more important? Your fluency and pronunciation. Content is not very important. Same like retail lecture, marks are going towards listening and speaking. So both content and fluency are important. So speaking is all about fluency, pronunciation, intonation. Listening and reading are more about content. And we've got Sanpreet. Hi Sanpreet. And Jack, ma'am, summarize written text always in past tense. No, Jack. Who told you that summarize has to be always in the past tense? No. It completely depends on the passage you have or the paragraphs you have, whether you are writing, you know, whether they are in the past, they are in the present, they are in the future. It completely depends on what you have. But there is no hard and fast rule that you have to write summarize in past tense. That's completely, if someone is telling you this, this is completely irrelevant information. Okay, coming back to our summarized spoken text, guys. Now, in summarized spoken text, there are a few guidelines which are to be followed. The first guideline says we have to write a summary using 50 to 70 words. So, guys, if the word count is mentioned, that means it is important. So, please do not breach the guidelines by writing less than 50 or writing more than 70 words. Second instruction says that you have 10 minutes to do the task. So, please make sure that you don't take more than 10 minutes. Use 10 minutes very wisely, you know, listen to the audio, organize your ideas, plan it, write it, and then make sure you revise it too. As I mentioned, the marks are important for spellings, grammatically correct sentences, so all those little things, starting the sentence with a capital letter, ending it with full stop, and wherever there is any punctuation required, wherever the tenses are used, make sure the tenses are correct. So please make sure all these little things which can actually help you score very well in your writing. And we have MD. Hi MD, and he's asking, is template for retail lecture and summarize written text the same? MD, we don't use any template for summarize written text. However, we use a template for summarize spoken text, and it is not same. You should not use same template. Yes, few of the words can be same. Okay, for example, you're using moreover, you can use furthermore. But in retail lecture, the aim is to speak fluently and cover the content. Whereas in summarized spoken text, the aim is to summarize it and form grammatically correct sentences. And in summarized written text, we just simply write one sentence. So how can a template help you? Okay, so in summarized written text, no template. Why? Because we have to summarize it using one sentence. The guidelines itself says one sentence. And we've got Chirag. Chirag, word limit. Word limit for summarized written text is 5 to 75, whereas word limit for summarized spoken text is 50 to 70. 50 to 70 words means generally 3 to 4 sentences. Could be 5 sentences rarely, but it completely depends on, you know, how long your sentences are and how well framed they are. So whenever you are writing summary, grammar is the most important thing. You take notes, same like retail lecture, but put those notes, put those words into grammatically correct sentences. Again, there is no need of making very, very long sentences, writing complex sentences, because whenever you write complex sentence, what happens is you make mistakes in terms of grammar and the whole idea becomes incorrect. So you can simply make small sentences, but try to be more accurate in terms of your grammar. Try to be more accurate in terms of summarizing the content, not just repeating the words. Now, covering the keywords is very important in your summarized spoken text. This task contributes, you know, it has more marks than your essays. So just make sure you use your template, you use the notes you have very, very wisely. Guys, if you have any other question about summaries or retail lecture or summarized written text, please feel free to post it in the comment section and I'll be more than happy to answer. Many students these days, they are actually struggling because what I've seen is that they are confusing retail with the summarized spoken text. So just avoid that mistake and try to be more focused on your grammar. And we've got MD again and he's asking, did the template change for retail lecture? It is the same these days. I have the template which I got 4 months back. MD, I'm not sure which template you have, but see, you can even make your own template. In retail lecture, there is actually, you know, the template is very simple. As I mentioned, the speaker was mainly talking about dash. Moreover, he mentioned dash. In addition, he added dash. Furthermore, he explained dash. In the lecture, I can also hear dash. In the lecture, he further described dash. So, you know, all these words. So you can also say, firstly, the speaker mentioned that. Secondly, he also added that. In addition, he also explained that. So there is no hard and fast template in retail lecture. Just make your own simple template, whatever is, you know, more comfortable for you, whichever words you can speak more fluently. Okay, so there is no hard and fast template. And we've got Sandeep again and she's asking, ma'am, I appeared PTE exam 2 times and I got only 10 in pronunciation. Due to my speaking score, I'm struggling in listening as well. How to improve pronunciation and how to access my pronunciation, please. Okay. Sandeep, I'm not sure what mistake you are making. Sometimes what happens is it could be the headphones. I'm not sure whether you're putting the headphones in the right. So if you've got a very thick voice, you can simply put it close to the jawline, like here. If you've got a very thin voice, try putting it close to your nose, tip of your nose, not under your nose because the air you breathe goes in. And let's see if I've got a... So these are the headphones you will be getting in your exam. So I believe if you've got a very thin voice, then don't put it here. Don't put it close to the chin. Try to put close to the tip of your nose. If you've got a very thick voice, then you can also put close to your jawline. Please make sure you do not touch this part when you are attempting a question. Okay, don't move the headphone over and over again. Don't touch this part, which will create unnecessary disturbance. So please make sure you follow this. Another thing is pronunciation sometimes can be low. There is a software, this app called Pitch Analyzer. You can always download that app and just see how that is scoring you for your pronunciation. Another thing I would recommend is please join our PT Tutorials Telegram Messenger group. If you join that group, you will be able to see that there are teachers who can actually help you with this query. You can always post your recording. So maybe you can do a read aloud or you can do a retell lecture and post it in that messenger, and you will be able to get good feedback for your query. And let's see if you've got the question. I hope I've answered the question. What is the minimum time for retail lecture? Chirag, for retail lecture, they say you have to give response within 40 seconds, but you try to speak for more, you know, for full 40 seconds, if not full, more than 35 seconds. Because the more you speak, the more content you cover, which is always good for your score in retail lecture. Because retail is all and all about the content and fluency. So more content, better listening score. Also guys, we have posted a link for the prediction file, which has got lots of repeated real exam questions. And you can see the scorecards we have posted on PT Tutorials Facebook page, and you can see that how many students are actually benefited from this prediction file. You can see their interviews, you can also see the, you know, their reviews which they have posted, and I'm sure students won't lie. We had 15 students last month who scored not 79, who scored more than 85 in their PT each. Okay, so I'm not saying individual, you know, overall, but each. So there were more than 15 students who actually scored close to 90 in PT. So of course we are doing something right. That is why the students are happy and they are scoring. So if you are struggling with any of the modules of PT, use the resources which we are providing. Some of them are absolutely free of cost. You don't pay anything. And make sure you choose reliable resources. Why I use the word reliable? Because there is so much of information available nowadays on Google, on YouTube about PT, and many of the channels, many of it is not very reliable. The more you listen, the more you get confused, the more you apply all the strategies, you know, you struggle to get the scores. So, you know, follow one or two resources, but please make sure, I'm not saying to follow us, but of course, if you do follow, follow the reliable resource. Follow a resource which can give you a reliable feedback too. If you have any other question, please feel free to post it in the comment section. And guys, another thing is that we have started, as I've mentioned before in the last video also, we started weekend classes which are actually doing really well. We have plenty of students now who are showing interest in weekend classes. It is giving benefit to all the students who are not able to come during the week. So if you are struggling to manage your time and you're working, studying and doing multiple things at the same time, avail the benefit of joining the weekend class, which is just a 4-hour class on Saturday and Sunday from 10 to 2, and you can actually clear your exam very, very soon, as many of our students are clearing these days. I would also like to congratulate Shubham, who just scored a perfect score of 86 in PT yesterday. So very heartiest congratulations to Shubham. He was a first time test taker. We've posted his scorecard again and you can have a look on that as well. And we've got a question from MD. Can we use 40 whole? No, don't use full 40 seconds in read aloud. Try to use much less than 40 seconds. You know, try to finish it off around 25 seconds. That would be great. Because if you use full 40 seconds, I'm sure you will not be very fluent. Because sometimes the sentences, the text is very small, maybe two sentences or three sentences. Of course, you should not be using full 40 seconds too. Read that thing. Whenever you finish, you know, whether you're finishing on 25 seconds, whether you're finishing on 16 seconds, or whether you're finishing at 36 seconds, please make sure you click next the very same moment. Don't wait for that blue bar, that recording bar to complete. And we've got Sandeep. In reading and writing fill in the blanks, I'm planning to memorize all repeated questions around 400. Will it work in real exam? Sandeep, it used to work, but nowadays lot of students are getting plenty of new questions in reading. Okay, so when anyone talks about the change in PT, that's the only change, that they keep on adding new material to it, which is quite fair enough. So, you know, memorizing those 400 fill in the blanks in a hope that you will be getting something, you know, from those fill in the blanks, or you would be getting everything from those fill in the blanks, might not help you a lot. But of course, practicing those 400 blanks will give you the confidence of solving many other blanks which could be quite similar. Another thing is that out of those 400 blanks, nowadays the blanks are not same. The content can be same, but the blanks are not same. So they can give you another blank in the same paragraph. So if you have practiced it, you will be able, if you have understood the context of it, you will be able to solve it. But if rattification is there, then I'm sorry, it might not help you. So try to, when you're doing reading and writing fill in the blanks, try to understand the context of the passage rather than focusing on the options. Because options are not important. The understanding of the context will give you answers straight away. Trust me, just follow the tenses used, just follow the word before the blank, after the blank, use of articles, where in a sentence is blank, how it is related to the next sentence, use of conjunctions. You know, for example, and is a positive connector. The word after the and will be of the same node. But is a negative connector. So word after but will be of a contrasting node. So all these little things can actually help you figure out the answer. And MD is saying, ma'am, I did message for online coaching. Please respond me on Facebook. MD, we'll have a look on Facebook. I'm not sure where you message. You can message it here and someone will answer that question for you. We've got Sidhu. Ma'am, how many marks of highlight correct summary? Highlight correct summary of listening, Sidhu, is not, yeah, it's not a quite high weightage task. The marks are going mainly towards your listening, and very few marks are going towards your listening. It is not a very high weightage task at all. Number of questions are generally 2 to 3, but the weightage of the task is quite less. So don't worry too much about it. The answer would be somewhere in the first 2-3 sentences or the last 2-3 sentences of the audio. Try to match, you know, the answer would have everything the speaker said, not just one part of it. Many times there are sentences, one similar sentence from the audio is there. Don't get confused, it is only reflecting one part of the audio. The word summarize itself means the complete idea. So the option will have something from start of the audio to the end of the audio. I hope it helps. And we've got Princess Joycey, and she's asking, I got 18 in spellings, how to improve? Princess, I would say that 18 in spellings doesn't mean that you have written, you know, most of the spellings incorrectly. It could be because you might have used a lot of backspace key. Every time you use backspace key, even to correct your spelling score will be affected. However, it will not impact your writing score. Until and unless actually your spellings are wrong and you're not at all confident about them, yes, then you need to practice. But if you are confident that your spellings are not that bad, it could be because you are using too much of backspace key. Try avoiding backspace key. Try to, you know, if you are correcting the full sentence or a big phrase, try to highlight and overwrite that rather than pressing the delete key or backspace key. And we've got Jack. Ma'am, I need 65. Where I focus more? Jack, I would say focus on read alouds, repeat sentences, retell lectures, summarizes, you know, summarize written, summarize spoken, reading and writing, fill in the blanks, and write from dictation. There are few, around 6 to 7 tasks, 8 tasks, I would say. If you master those 8 tasks, you can not only score 65, you can actually score 79. So these 8-9 tasks are the most important tasks of PTA. All the MCQs, highlight, correct summaries, select missing words, these are not quite high weightage tasks. So try and focus more on the other areas. And Sanpreet wants to ask something. Sanpreet, please post your question. And we've got Randhir. Hi ma'am, I need 60. Where I have to focus? Randhir, as I said, you're speaking, from speaking, a lot of marks goes towards reading and listening. So try to be really good with your speaking, not in terms of fluency only, but in terms of the content too. Focus on all the types of summaries, whether they summarize written text or summarize spoken text. And focus more on reading and writing, fill in the blanks. Focus on your write from dictation. All these are very, very high weightage tasks. And I hope it will help you to get 60. And we've got Randhir, 6 in IELTS. Randhir, IELTS spelling. So if you're not writing IELTS correct spelling, how will you score 6 in IELTS? Tell me. So switch to PTE. Okay. PTE is much easier than IELTS. So if you have any questions regarding PTE, please feel free to post it in the comment section. Guys, we will finish today's session. I hope it can help. It might help you in one way or the other. If you have any other question, please feel free to post it in the comment section. You can also visit our Facebook page, which is PTE Tutorials. If you have to ask me something, you can visit the page Tanu Aussies, and I'll be more than happy to answer all your queries. And if you are looking to join coaching, we are Aussies Clayton, in Clayton suburb. And we have classes Monday to Friday, 10 to 12 in the morning, 6 to 8 in the evening. We do have weekend classes, which is Saturday and Sunday from 10 to 2. And trust me, guys, you won't regret joining here. We've got plenty of success stories, plenty of students who actually got their, you know, dream of getting their residency through us. And you can call on 0430-88-7072 to make a booking for the free trial class also. And let's answer the last few questions. In write from dictation, do we need to put full stop at the end? Will affect if you don't put it? Yes, because the marks are going towards writing. Writing is grammar. What is your grammar? Grammar is your punctuation and your tenses. And full stop is a punctuation mark. So, starting the sentence with a capital letter. If there is any proper noun, capital letter. If there needs to be a comma, please put a comma. And at the end of the sentence, you have to put a full stop. And we've got Jack. Thanks, ma'am. You're most welcome, Jack. I hope it helps you. And we've got Parth. Listening, fill in the blanks, repeat in PT. Yes, they do sometimes repeat in PT. You can practice them from PT tutorials. Please make sure that you are good with spellings. If you are not very good with spellings, you might lose plenty of marks because this is a very high weightage task. Don't take it lightly. Even if you miss S, for example, the answer to question is exists and you have just written exist, you will lose marks because exist will be considered completely incorrect. And thank you, MD. How to improve the fluency? Time your speaking. So when you are doing a read aloud, retell, lecture, describe image, time it. And try to finish a read aloud in less than 25 seconds. So Lakshmikant, when you are practicing, time your speaking and try to finish your read alouds in less than 25 seconds. And when you are practicing, stand in front of the mirror and try to say things quickly. Now, of course, fluency doesn't mean quickly or fastly. Fluency means, you know, free flowing speech without any fillers or these words, or without any unnecessary pauses. So try to avoid those pauses. Just a very, very slight pause on the commas and a very slight pause on the full stop or any other punctuation mark. And rest everything, try to read phrases together, not words individually. So guys, thank you so much. And we will see you hopefully next week. Thank you.